A better way to do a martini than invite my friends down from Dirty Tequila. We have, of course, George Dewar, the founder figure, the father figure, the owner, the creator of Dirty Tequila, and Corbin, Quarterback Jones, as they call you. We're going to delve into that in the next few weeks and figure out why they call you that, Corbin.
I had a bar back in Arizona, just used to make drinks, playing around for people. Love to be a bartender. So just like everybody else, I would throw a bunch of stuff in a glass and throw it out. One day somebody asked me to make something with tequila. I grabbed tequila, turned around, grabbed some sweetener, grabbed some flavors, threw it in a glass, threw it out. It looked dirty, so I called it Dirty Tequila in there.
And they loved it, and so you decided to bottle it. Now, what a great success story is that, by chance, if you will. But you know, a lot of thought goes into Dirty Tequila. You might, Corbin, am I right? I mean, he makes it sound so easy, but you guys took the passion behind making it. The passion behind the packaging and the marketing. I mean, tell me a little bit about that.
Well, it really is a simple drink, for one thing. But yes, the packaging, the marketing behind it, the name Dirty, the symbol of the girl in the name of the drink, all points to fun and flirty and having a good time.
Absolutely. And we're having a good time here as we're talking martinis now. Reese, I'm going to ask you what you think of it, so start sipping on that. But what we did here is Carrie, our mixologist, mixed it up. He started with a shaker with ice, Dirty Tequila, added apple cider in there and shook it up. Now the martini glass he started, he rimmed it with caramel and poured the martini in there and then garnished it with an apple. What's great about rimming the glass with caramel, and I think you had said this, George, is it with every sip you get that great taste of caramel.
Get a little sweetness from the caramel.
Now tell everybody what Dirty Tequila is. I mean, I taste these flavors. What are the flavors I'm tasting?
What we did is we took the drink I used to make in Arizona, we went down to Mexico, we start with 110 proof, silver blue agave tequila, great tequila. We take the six main flavors from the drink that I used to make, we infuse it into the tequila, bring it down to 72 proof, makes it a great tasting tequila. You don't need training wheels, you can knock it back, or you make drinks like this because of all the flavors come out in different ways when you mix them. Right.
Now there's a cinnamon on it, there's a, Reese, what do you think of the cocktail first of all as a martini?
Oh, overall it's fantastic. I really love the flavors of it. The cinnamon really mixes well with that, which is, and the caramel really does have that taste of sweetness right
there.
Well,
we call it a dirty granny.
The dirty granny because of the apple right there. Check it out, all the fun, all the flavors, hotmixology.com, and all the recipes are gonna be on there. Hit the featured brands page, hit up Dirty Tequila because you gotta get this into your home, into your bar. Everywhere. Now you're going to hang out with us for the next few weeks here. We're in Denver, Colorado, hanging out at Reese's spot where he has over 500 different selections of tequila here. And now one of the great tequilas, 501, I was going to say that, right. The Dirty Tequila right there on the shelf is Hot Mixology. Hanging out with my friends from Dirty Tequila, having a great time. It's martinis on Hot Mixology. We're going to be right back. Salute, everybody.
Salute.